Hello students, this is Priyanka. Today I am going to help you out in studying biology class 6, and today we are going to deal with chapter number 1, that is the leaf. All of you know that plants are the living structure because plant also require air to breathe, food to survive. From these very features we can easily predict out that plants are the living things. Now the important parts of the plant. All of you have seen the plants. So, what are the important parts of the plant? Roots, stem, branches, leaves, flowers and fruits. Here in figure 1.1, you can see the labelings. Okay, so what is the function of the leaf? Its function is to prepare the food for the plant, and it is known as the kitchen of the plant. Stem keeps the plant upright position. That means stem keeps the plant straight. Okay. And it is the connecting link between the roots and the rest part of the plant. It also transports water and minerals to rest of the portion of the plant. Now root. Root remain under the soil. Its function is to absorb water and minerals from the soil and transport it to the rest of the portion of the plant. Now we are going to deal with external structure of a leaf. All of you have seen the leaf. What are the leaf? Leaf are the thin, broad, flat, green structure. Okay. And they are attached to the stem. Plural of leaf is leaves. And leaves of different plants are different in shapes and sizes. You have seen some of the elongated leaves, very long leaves, very short leaf. Have you seen the banana leaf? Have you seen the rose leaf? So much difference in their shape and size. So leaf basically have two important parts, that is lamina and petiole. So lamina is also known as the leaf blade and petiole is known as the leaf stalk. Just see the figure 1.2. You can see the labelings, na? Different labelings. You can see the stem. You can see the outer uneven margins. That is leaf blade. That means it is lamina. You can also see the connecting link. That is petiole. It is connecting the leaf to the stem. You can see midrib. Midrib is the center portion of the leaf. You can see the veins that is connected to the midrib. Okay. And their number is very, very large. Okay. The leaves, these veins are arising from the midrib. And this midrib is the center portion of the lamina. Okay. Fine. Now, petiole. Petiole are the thin stalk-like structure, they are connecting the leaf to the stem. Now midrib, it is a center portion which is dividing the whole lamina into two portions. Now veins are arising from the midrib and they are present all over the surface of the leaf and they perform the function of the transportation of water and food to rest of the portion of the leaves. Now stomata. Stomata are the structures that can't be observed by our naked eyes. To have a look of the stomata, we have to see the leaves under the microscope. And the important function that is performed by stomata is they help in the respiration. Okay, they look after the inlet and outlet of the gases from the surface of the leaf. And if a leaf has accumulated extra water, that extra water is removed from the leaf surface in the form of water vapor. Here in the figure you can see one of the diagrammatic representation of a single stoma. Okay, stomata is a plural form, single is stoma. Okay, one single stoma has been shown over here. Now chlorophyll is very, very important for the plants because they provide the color to the plant. That green color of the leaves is because of the presence of chlorophyll, and they absorb the energy from the sun. That energy is being utilized in the preparation of food by the leaf. Now kinds of leaf, basically there are two types of leaf, that is simple leaf. Here in the figure 1.4 you can see this, there are two kinds of leaf, that is simple leaf and the compound leaf. You can see here the simple leaf have the regular margin, no incision, no cut mark is over there. That means it is simple leaf. And here in the compound leaf, you can see from a single stalk, so many leaflets are coming out. तो दिस अरेंजमेंट ऑफ लीव्स इज नोन एज द कंपाउंड लीव्स. एग्जाम्पल ऑफ सिंपल लीफ इज मैंगो, रेडिश, बनियन, पपाया. एंड एग्जाम्पल्स ऑफ द कंपाउंड लीव्स इज नीम, रोज, प्रिकी पॉपी. क्लियर? नाउ वेनेशियन. सो वेनेशियंस, व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय वेनेशियन? वेनेशियंस मीन्स अरेंजमेंट ऑफ द वेन्स. यू हैव सीन ना, दीज आर द वेन्स. ओके, इन द फिगर, कम बैक टू द फिगर 1.2. हियर यू हैव सीन द वेन्स. नाउ वेन्स आर राइजिंग फ्रॉम द मिडरिब. सो वेनेशियन मीन्स द अरेंजमेंट ऑफ दीज वेन्स. वेन्स आर अरेंज्ड इन द लीव्स इन अ डिफरेंट पैटर्न्स. So basically that pattern has been divided into two parts, that is reticulate venation and the parallel venation. Now come to the figure 1.5. Here you can see two different kind of leaves showing different type of venations. So this very venation is known as a reticulate venation because veins are arising from different portion of the midrib and they're unevenly distributed. They're just crisscross present in the man, crisscrossing each other and forming net-like structure. This kind of venation is known as the reticulate venations. While in the parallel venation, you can see that midrib is present in the between and the veins are arising at equal portion on both the sides of the leaves. This kind of pattern is known of veins is known as the parallel veins. So examples of the reticulate venation is tulsi, mustard, sunflower, rose, peepal, coriander. An example of parallel venation is wheat, bamboo, barley, sugarcane, lily, banana, etc. Now coming back to functions of leaf. So three important functions performed by the leaves are: first, preparation of food, that is by process of photosynthesis. Second, the leaves get rid of extra water from the surface of leaf through transpiration. Okay, if the leaves get extra water, they remove it in the form of water vapor from the surface of the leaves, and this process is known as a transpiration. Then third one, carry out the process of respiration, that means production of energy. Here you can see one of the word representation, carbon dioxide plus water in the presence of sunlight and chlorophyll, food and oxygen. That means plant take in carbon dioxide plus water from the leaf, and these two combine together in the presence of sunlight and chlorophyll and form food and oxygen. For they manufacture food in the presence of light, and then they release the oxygen into the atmosphere. Now chlorophyll are present in the green leaves, and the main function of chlorophyll is to trap the solar energy, and that energy is used in the manufacturing of the food. Oxygen is released in the process of the photosynthesis, and the food prepared by the leaves is actually glucose. And if the plant manufacture extra glucose, they are stored in the plant in the form of the starch in different parts of the plant. Plant, what they do, they store the extra food, they store the extra glucose in the form of starch. And the term photosynthesis actually means making things with the light. That's why it's known as photosynthesis. Photo means light. Here you can see, let's do it. It's a very simple thing what you're supposed to do. This is actually your assignment. You have to collect any four leaves around your area. You are not supposed to move out of your house. In your house, in your garden, wherever it is present, you have to collect four kinds of leaves. You have to take it, soak it in a water, and after the interval of every 2 days, you have to change the water. And on the completion of 1 week, you will see that the lamina will just move out, and you can find out what kind of venation. Okay, you have to observe what kind of venation it is having, whether it's having reticulate venation or it's having the parallel venation. Okay, then it's a simple activity given over here to find out whether the photosynthesis that plants show make food by the process of photosynthesis. So here the green leaves is taken from the plant that is plotted in the sun. Okay, you have to take the leaf of the plant that is which is growing up in the sunlight, in the presence of sunlight. And that green leaf you will put it in a small beaker, and then you are supposed to add alcohol or spirit. Okay, then that small beaker that is having the green leaf and having the alcohol, you are supposed to keep it over one of the bigger beaker. Okay, here in the figure you can see it is a green plant, it's plotted in the sunlight. You have to retake one of the green leaf, then put this green leaf into a smaller beaker having the alcohol, and this very beaker you are supposed to arrange it over the larger beaker having the water in this very main manner, and you are supposed to heat it. Then what is going to happen, this very water in the beaker is going to get warm up, and subsequently this heat is going to be transferred to the smaller beaker and it will also start warming up. After some time, what you're supposed to do, because of the alcohol, what will happen, this leaf will get decolorized. Okay, this green color will come out. As the green color of the leaves come out, take out the leaf from this alcohol and wash the leaf. In case it's having the chlorophyll, it will just move out. Then you will take this decolorized leaf, keep it in another petri dish and add few drops of the iodine. Then what will happen, it will show the blue black structure. That means starch was present. That means these leaves were storing the extra food in the form of the starch. That is now confirmed. Clear? It's a simple activity. Students, here I have given 5 questions. Whatever portion I have taught, on the basis of that, I have framed these 5 questions. These are very easy questions. You are going to get the answers directly from the book. You are supposed to prepare the answer for it and try to prepare in some separate copy. On the reopening of the school, I will be correcting these very questions. And you have seen that in my book, I have underlined it so many lines with the pencil. That is the important points. Okay. Thank you, students.